vamos y sin censura. Yo te hago todo a ti dulzura. ¿Qué pasó en ti?
Many believe that the romantic novel by the Colombian writer Jorge Isaacs is one of the greatest works of Spanish-American literature. Some critics believe that this novel is in fact an autobiography of Isaacs' own tragic love life. In the quiet and beautiful department of Valle del Cauca, where its residents spend their peaceful days basking in its boundless nature, there live two young people, Maria and Efraín, cousins. Both lived in the same hacienda with their families. The two spent most of their childhood playing outside with all the other children of the hacienda, and their familial bonds grew strong. However, as days went by, and as innocent boys and girls grew into mature men and women, the passionate fire of love began to smolder in their hearts. Maria and Efraín had known each other for years and had lived under the same roof for even longer. They knew all there was to know about each other, and the blossoming buds of love between the two of them shouldn't have come as a surprise. Sadly, theirs was a forbidden love. The two were cousins and therefore family. Their love was not acceptable, and it was something the two had to take to their graves. They told themselves they would be happy to spend their days like this, but fate had set its cruel gaze on the two, and it was not going to back down. Efraín's family decides to send him off to study in Bogotá, the capital of Colombia, for 6 years. For Maria, 6 years feel like 6 decades and more. Somehow she pulls through, and days turn into months, and months into years, until Efraín finally returns back. Although the long years he'd spent at the capital should have made him into a different man, they did not. Efraín was still the same Efraín Maria had always loved and waited to embrace. However, their newfound happiness is short-lived. Efraín leaves for London after 3 months to study medicine, and with him, he takes a part of Maria. Maria lives her days with a broken heart, her letters to Efraín the only tether keeping her in this world. No one knows that her time is running out, and when Efraín finally returns back home after 2 years, he realizes that Maria is no more, that her frail body couldn't function with a broken heart anymore. With a heart full of spite, Efraín leaves his home, never to return. Que ahora tú sabes bien lo que vamos a hacer.